Hello everyone, in this video lecture we'll be doing some more questions on how to find the highest normal form of a particular relation. Okay, so yeah, let's start the session. So yeah, let's start with the very first question. Okay, so this question says that given a relation R which has attributes from R to H, and we have a functional dependency set FD which has these functional dependencies. Okay, and what is the highest normal form of the table T? So yeah, we have to find out the highest normal form. So with given FDs and relation, so let's try to find out the highest normal form. Okay, so in order to find out the highest normal form, we have to find out the candidate keys first, right? So if you try to find out the candidate keys of this relation, then the candidate key will come as AB. Okay, so AB will be the one and only candidate key of this relation. So now we have the candidate key, so we can find out that what are the prime and non-prime attributes, right? So where A, B are the prime attributes, and from C to H are the non-prime attributes, right? A, B are prime attributes because A, B are a part of at least one candidate keys. Okay, so we have prime and non-prime attributes. Now let's try to find out the in which normal form basically this relation is. Okay, so for DCNF testing, we have to see, like, for every non-trivial functional dependency X to Y, we have to see that X is always a super key, isn't it? So let's check every functional dependency one by one. So if you see the first one, which is AB in the LHS, that is the determinant is AB, right? So in this functional dependency, AB is a super key, isn't it? So this satisfies the property to be in BCNF. What about the next functional dependency? That is, from A, we are getting the value of DE, right? So A is not at all a super key. So this functional dependency doesn't satisfy the property to be in BCNF, right? So the relation is not in BCNF. What about 3NF? So for 3NF, we know that the condition is for any non-trivial functional dependency X to Y, we have to see whether X is a super key or Y is prime, right? So let's check one by one. So we know for the first one that AB is a super key. So this satisfies the property. What about the next one? So A is not a super key, but whether D is prime or not. So you can see that DE is not a prime attribute, right? D is a non-prime and E is a non-prime. So you can see that this functional dependency, that is from A to B get the value of DE, this functional dependency doesn't satisfy any of the property, right? Neither A is a super key nor DE are the prime attribute. So it doesn't satisfy the property to be in 3NF. Okay, so yeah, the relation is also not in 3NF. Now we'll check for 2NF, and for 2NF we know that there must not be any partial dependency, right? That is, from prime attribute we get a non-prime attribute, and this prime attribute is a subset of candidate key. Okay, so let's check one by one. So we know that AB is our candidate key, isn't it? So this is not a subset, so this will satisfy 2NF property. What about this one? So we know that from A we are getting DE, right? And A is a subset of this candidate key, isn't it? So A is a subset of this candidate key, so this is prime, and DE are the non-prime attributes, isn't it? So from prime attribute, we are getting a value of non-prime attribute, right? So this is nothing but partial dependency only. And if partial dependency exists in a relation, then that relation is not in 2NF. Okay, so it is not in 2NF. So it is obviously in 1NF, isn't it? Because every relation in RDBMS is in 1NF. Okay, so yeah, this one is in 1NF. The highest normal form of this relation is 1NF. Okay, so now we'll see the next example. So the question 2 is, consider a database table T with attributes A to E, and then set of functional dependencies. These are the set of functional dependencies. Okay, what is the highest normal form of the table T? So same thing. So let's try to find out the candidate keys and the prime attributes, and then we'll find out the normal forms. Okay. And if you try to find out the candidate keys of this relation, the candidate keys of this relation will be AC, AD, and AE, okay? So now we know the candidate keys of this relation, isn't it? So from here, we can see that, like, what are the prime and non-prime attributes, isn't it? So here you can see that except B, all are prime attributes. So B is basically non-prime, and A is prime, C is prime, D is prime, and E is prime. Okay, so now let's check for BCNF. Okay, so for BCNF, we know that the condition is for any non-trivial functional dependency x to y, x must be a super key, isn't it? So let's take one by one every functional dependency, and you can see that the first functional dependency, the LHS, that is the determinant AE, is a super key, right? Because you can see AE is a candidate key, so it's also a super key. Hence, the first functional dependency satisfies the property to be in BCNF. Okay. So what about the second one? So AC is also a super key, right? What about the third one? CD is not a super key, isn't it? CD is not a super key, so this one doesn't satisfy the property to be in BCNF, right? And even if any of the functional dependency doesn't satisfy the property, then the whole relation is not in BCNF. What about 3NF? So for 3NF, let's try to check. And the condition was, for every non-trivial functional dependency x to y, either x should be a super key or y should be prime, right? So let's check one by one every functional dependency. We know that AE is a super key, so this is okay. We know that AC is a super key, so this is also okay. What about this one, CD? So we know CD is not a super key. Now let's try to find out whether BE is a prime or not. Okay, so for CD to BE, so CD is not a super key. What about BE? So if I try to decompose this, then from CD we can get the value of P, and from CD we can get the value of E, right? So this one satisfies the property to be in 3NF because E is our prime attribute, isn't it? But this one doesn't satisfy the property to be in BCNF because B is a non-prime attribute, isn't it? So CD is not a super key, and B also is not a prime attribute, right? So this doesn't satisfy any of the property, so the relation is not in BCNF, right? What about 2NF? For 2NF, we know that there should not be any partial dependency, right? So what is partial dependency? Partial dependency is nothing but from prime attribute, if we are getting a non-prime attribute, and this prime attribute is nothing but a subset of candidate key. And if this type of dependency exists, then the relation is not in 2NF, right? So let's check one by one every functional dependency. So for the first one, we know that AE is already a candidate key, right? It's not a subset, so this one is okay. What about second one? So AC is also candidate key, so this one is also okay. What about CD? So CD is not a subset of any candidate key. Okay, so leave it right now. So if you see this one, that is from D to E, D is a subset of candidate key AD, right? So D is a subset of candidate key AD. So this is prime. What about E? So E is our prime attribute, okay? So from prime attribute, we are getting a value of prime attribute, isn't it? So this is not a partial dependency, because partial dependency is that from prime we are getting non-prime. Okay, so please don't get confused. So this is not a partial dependency. Okay, so now we are left with only the third functional dependency, that is from CD to we are getting the value of BE, right? So if our if we are having some functional dependency that is not a subset of any candidate key, then we do 2NF testing, as I said in a previous lecture. So we have to do the 2NF testing. And what was the 2NF testing? We have to take the subset of every candidate key and find out the closure of that. And if that closure contains any non-prime attribute, then that is called a partial dependency. Okay. So let's take the subset of every candidate key. So for AC, the subsets are A and C. And then for AD, the subsets are A and D. And then for AE, the subsets are A and E, right? So for A closure, let's try to find out the A closure. So A closure will give me A only. So we are getting prime attribute only. What about C closure? So C closure will give me C only. What about A closure? So A closure is A only. What about D closure? So D closure will give me D. And then from D, we are getting E, right? So D closure is giving me D, and from D, we are getting E. So E is also a prime attribute only. It's a prime attribute, so not a problem right now. Okay. So A closure is giving me A again. What about E closure? So E closure is giving me E only. Okay. So here you can see that any of the closure is not containing any non-prime attribute, right? That is, from subset of any of the candidate key, we are not getting any non-prime attribute, right? So from prime attribute to non-prime attribute, this kind of dependency is not possible. And this is nothing but a partial dependency, right? So partial dependency is not possible in this relation. So that is why if partial dependency is not possible in this relation, then the relation is always in 2nf. Okay. So the relation is in 2nf. And like if this was MSQ question, that is multiple select question, then we know that every 2nf is also 1nf, right? So A and B will be correct, both correct. Okay. And if it was a MCQ question, then only we have to select 2nf. I mean the highest normal form. Okay. That is why it's asking the highest normal form. So the highest number form is 2nf. Okay, so now we'll see the next question. So this question says find the highest number form of a relation R which has attributes A, B, C, D, E and with FD set as these are the FDs. Okay, so again the candidate keys for this relation will be A, C only. Okay, so you can find out as the conventional way. So A, C is our candidate key. So what about the prime and non-prime? So A is our prime, B non-prime, C is prime, D non-prime, and E non-prime. Right, so we have prime and non-prime attribute. Now let's try to test for every normal form, okay? So for BCNF is for every non-trivial functional dependency X to Y, X must be a super key, isn't it? So X must be a super key, so let's test for every FD. So we know that BC is not a super key, right? So this doesn't satisfy the property to be in BCNF. So the relation is not in BCNF. What about 3NF? For every non-trivial functional dependency X to Y, either X should be a super key or Y should be a prime attribute. Right, so let's test. So this one, you can see that BC is not a super key, right? Also, D is a non-prime attribute. So this FD doesn't satisfy the property to be in 3NF. So the relation is not in 3NF. Also, in other way, like if I see this one, if you see this one, B is a non-prime attribute, you can see here, and E is also a non-prime attribute. So I've told you that if these kind of functional dependency exist, then the relation is not at all in 3NF, right? So what about 2NF? There must not be any partial dependency, right? So let's see whether any partial dependency exists or not. So BC is not a subset of any candidate key. AC is a candidate key, so leave this is okay. Okay, what about B to E? So B is not a subset of any candidate key, right? So this is also okay. What about this one, BC? So for this one and this one, for this one and this one, that is the first and third one, okay, the LHS is not a part of or a subset of any candidate key, right? So for this kind of functional dependency, we have to check for 2NF testing. So let's test for 2NF testing. So which is for the subset of candidate keys, that is A subset will be A and C. We have to find out the closure, right? So A closure will be A only and C closure will be C only, right? So from prime, we are getting prime attributes only, right? So there is no chance that we can get a non-prime attribute from this prime attribute. So there is no prime to non-prime exist where P is a subset of candidate key. So if this kind of functional dependency doesn't exist, then the relation is always in 2NF. Okay, then the relation is in 2NF only. Now let's see the fourth question. So the fourth question is given a relation R which has attributes A, B, C, D, E and the following FDs. So these are the following FDs. Okay, so which is the highest normal form the table is in? So basically we have to find out the normal form. So for that we have to find out the candidate keys. So the candidate keys of the relation will be A, B, C and C, D. Okay, so the highest normal form of this relation is, in order to find that, we have to find out the prime and non-prime attribute. So we can see that one thing, that for this relation R, all the attributes are prime attributes only, because all the attributes are a part of at least one candidate key, right? A is a part of this, B is a part of this, C is a part of this, at least this and this, and D is a part of this one, right? So all the attributes are a part of at least one prime, like any at least one candidate keys, right? So I have told you in the note section of the 3NF that if all the attributes of the particular relation are prime attributes, then that kind of relation are always in 3NF, right? So please remember that point. Okay, so you can see here that all the attributes are prime. So blindly mark C as the correct option, because all the attributes are prime. And if all the attributes are prime, the relation is always in 3NF. Okay, So it will be 3NF, and if you want to verify this, you can verify. Okay, so let's test. Okay, so let's test BCNF first. So BCNF first, for BCNF for any non-trivial functional dependency x to y, x should be super key, right? So you can see that A is a super key, so this is okay. BC is a super key, so this is okay. But D is not a super key, right? So this is not in BCNF. What about 3NF? For any non-trivial functional dependency x to y, x should be a super key or y should be prime. So we know that A is a super key, so this is okay. What about BC? So BC is also a super key, so this is also okay. D is not a super key, but B is prime attribute, isn't it? So B is prime attribute, so this one is also okay. So all the functional dependence satisfies our property to be in 3NF, right? So yeah, this relation is in 3NF. And if this is in 3NF, this is also in 2NF, this is also in 1NF. Okay. So yeah, this was all about the session. Thank you guys. I hope you learned something from this. And yeah, we'll meet in our next session. Okay.